Good evening. Good evening. Welcome to all of you. It is good to have you here for this year's Christmas Cantata. On behalf of our choir and our music people, we are so happy that you turned out on this rather chilly evening. So again, it's so good to have you here. We're going to begin by singing a familiar Christmas hymn, hymn number 45. We ask that you remain seated during the hymn as the choir will be processing in. And as soon as the hymn is over, we begin the program.
Thank you. Rejoice and sing with joy, for unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Rejoice and sing with joy.
Joy, 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 joy.
also began earlier than usual in the village. As night gave way to dawn, people were already on the streets. Vendors were positioning themselves on the corners of the most heavily traveled avenues. Store owners were unlocking the doors to their shops. Children were awakened by the exciting barking of the street dogs and the complaints of donkeys pulling carts. One's imagination is kindled thinking about the conversation of the innkeeper and his family at the breakfast table. Did anyone mention the arrival of the young couple the night before? Did anyone ask about their welfare? Did anyone comment on the pregnancy of the girl on the donkey? No, it is doubtful that anyone mentioned the couple's arrival or wondered about the condition of the girl. They were too busy. The day was upon them. The day's bread had to be made. The morning chores had to be done. There was too much to do to imagine that the impossible had occurred. God had entered the world as a baby. Meanwhile, the city hums. The merchants are unaware that God has visited their planet. The innkeeper would never believe that he had just sent God into the cold. And the people would scoff at anyone who told them the Messiah lay in the arms of a teenager on the outskirts of their village. They were all too busy to consider the possibility. Those who missed His Majesty's arrival that night missed it not because of evil acts or malice. No, they missed it because they simply weren't looking. Only a few bewildered and fearful shepherds were present when Gabriel and a host of angels announced the arrival of Jesus, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Be not afraid, I have good news for you. Be not afraid, I have good news for you.
Thank you.
this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bones. Still, Father, this baby be the Son of my love. Emmanuel, our God is with us, and if God is with us, stand against us. Our God is with us.
Enjoy the silence of the crib, for the noise of confusion rumbles in your future. Savor the sweet safety of my arms, for a day is soon coming when I cannot protect you. Rest well, tiny hand, for though you belong to a king, you will touch no satin, own no gold. You will grasp no pen, guide no brush. Know your tiny hands are reserved for work more precious. To touch a leper's open wound, to wipe a widow's weary tear, to claw the ground of Gethsemane. Sleep deeply, tiny eyes. Sleep while you can, for soon the blurriness will clear, and you will see the mess we have made of your world. You will see our nakedness, for we cannot hide. You will see our selfishness, for we cannot give. You will see our pain, for we cannot heal. Lay still, tiny mouth. Lay still, mouth from which eternity will speak. Tiny tongue that will soon summon the dead, that will define grace, that will silence our foolishness. And tiny feet cupped in the palm of my hand, rest, for many difficult steps lie ahead for you. Do you taste the dust of the trails you will travel? Do you feel the cold seawater upon which you will walk? Do you you wrench at the invasion of the nails you will bear? Do you fear the steep descent down the spiral staircase into Satan's domain? Rest, tiny feet. Rest today so that tomorrow you might walk with power. Rest, for millions will follow in your steps.
Oh, little baby, Sing no.
It all happened in a moment, a most remarkable moment. As moments go, that one appeared no different than any other. If you could somehow pick it up off the timeline and examine it, it would look exactly like the ones that have passed while you heard these words. It came and it went. It was preceded by others just like it. It was one of the countless moments that have marked time since eternity became measurable. But in reality, that particular moment was like none other. For through that segment of time, a spectacular thing occurred. God became a man. While the creatures of earth walked unaware, divinity arrived.
Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
became flesh, the world will see another instant transformation. You see, in becoming man, God made it possible for man to see God. When Jesus went home, he left the back door open. As a result, we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye.
Pressure will continue to pull away from Wisconsin tonight and take aim on the northeast United States.